Fishin Affliction. Hello.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time. For those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and the big dog's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a biggin', yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah. Yeah, and we've got it bad.
I've got that fishing affliction.
Hey, I'm Art Defoe, and I've got that fishing affliction.
Hi, I'm Denny Brower, and I've got that fishing affliction.
Hey, I'm Mark Menendez, and I've got that fishing affliction.
I'm Bobby Lane, and I got that fishing affliction.
Hi, I'm Chris Lane, and I got that fishing affliction.
I'm Shaw Grigsby, and I got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, here.
Now, we got the best good luck charm on Fishin Affliction TV. She's never not going to be in the boat.
Always going to go now.
The first 5 minutes, there we are right there.
Well, folks, it's time to wet a line because it's Fishin Affliction time. And welcome into today's episode, Spawin Time, featuring some great fishing action from J. Percy Priest Lake and Old Hickory. And, folks, we're catching some big old fish. Today's Fishin Affliction product spotlight is on the great line selection from Seaguar. Be sure to check out all that great Fishin Affliction gear that's there at our online store. And if you can't get enough Fishin Affliction TV, then subscribe to us there at our YouTube channels. And at the end of the show, you'll meet the Fishin Affliction Facebook Friend of the Week. So sit back and enjoy some great fishing action from Percy Priest and Old Hickory, because it's spawning time right here on Fishin Affliction TV.
Fishing stories with the big dog. Big dog, what kind of fishing story today will you think we'll be seeing on Percy Priest?
Well, folks, on last week's episode, the big dog and I were pulling his beautiful Ranger boat, heading to Percy Priest Lake to fish the priest spawn, trying to catch those fish that are moving up and making those beds. And on the way there, I couldn't help but tease the big dog just a little bit about that big old hickory rockfish that I had just caught a few days before we went to Percy Priest.
Well, I've been good for 17 to 23 pounds on old hickory. What can you put me on today? Of course, that's a modified weight.
Yeah. And you're throwing one rockfish in with your bass weight still.
You know, there is a big jealousy with that. How big is your biggest rockfish?
We don't want to talk about that on television, being as this is a bass show.
All right. Well, the adventures of the day of Fishin Affliction TV are just about to begin. Don't be upset about the rockfish. He's upset. It was a big old fish. That was a big fish.
Well, folks, I couldn't help but tease the big dog just a little bit about that big old rockfish, but we were heading to Percy Priest to fish the pre-spawn, fishing for those big old largemouths, and that's exactly what we did.
Look where he's got the bait. Right in the bottom of his jaw, he picked it up off that spot and come out with it. I guess that is a female. But anyway.
Nice fish.
That's a solid little chunk. Well, you know, we throw that first one back. I'm putting this one in there because we've been quite a long time without being able to get one in the boat. You hear me? Okay.
Good one right here, big dog.
Yeah, that's a good solid fish right there.
This is on the rage crawl.
Yeah, that's what you're hunting for right there now. Now that's a better fish. That's a solid one.
Yep.
I guess you can put that one in the box, Dan. Why do you look at fish's bellies? I'm starting to be a little concerned with you.
It's just that magical time of the year, big dog. Got some beautiful fish in it. Strike King Rage Crawl? Awesome. What size mine?
Oh, we have size. We don't Put it any side you want to. I want you to be happy today. But I'm going to tell you one thing. By the end of the day, you won't want to have sides. I promise you that.
That's a beautiful fish, isn't it, big dog?
That's a good one.
Around 3 pounds or so?
Yeah. Okay.
Do you see the way I kept that one on the hook?
Go.
Big doggy. Woo! Strike king.
Ah. That's a better fish. That's a better one.
Man, you just said pick up the flipping stick.
Well, that fish strike definitely king. On bed.
Yeah. How about that, huh?
That's a good one.
Woo! And people are calling already. That's cool. How big? High fours?
Oh, that's probably 5 pounder, yeah.
My side, big doggy. My side.
That's a good one.
Came right out where he should have been to.
That's a good one. Good job, man. Good job.
Is that fun or what, man? That is cool.
That's cool. Come out of one of them cracks.
Well, folks, the big dog and myself are enjoying some great fishing fun because it's spawning time there on Percy Priest. And in a moment, we'll be right back with some more fishing action from the wilds of Percy Priest from that day of fishing. But speaking of in the wilds, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild.
Jim Morrow has been catching those Percy Priest slabs all year, and here is another big one. And Mike Dial knows how to catch these beautiful smallmouths without a boat and getting those feet just a little bit wet. Great fish, Michael. And as the water's heating up, so isn't Nick Malincourt. Look at this gigantic largemouth. And Affliction Pro staffer Toby Lillard knows how to celebrate retiring from the U.S. Army by going fishing and catching biggins. Folks, you can send your pictures to pics@fishandaffliction.com and be sure to upload them to our Facebook page, and maybe you'll see them right here on the big screen.
In the wild. Your pictures in the wild.
At Strike King, it starts with the concept. Next, it's all about perfecting the prototype. Finally, it's about catching a dream.
This is a new prototype crankbait we're working on. Strike King. It's called a 10XD.
Strike King 10XD.
Wow! A 5-pass limit!
Perfection to 25 feet and beyond. Catch your dream.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several convenient locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism.
Every year, boaters are injured or killed by a colorless, odorless gas called carbon monoxide. Most of these incidents occur in enclosed areas of the boat.
A few ways to prevent these injuries include installing a carbon monoxide detector in enclosed areas of your boat and venting these areas well, scheduling regular engine maintenance, and not allowing anyone to swim near the boat's engine.
All carbon monoxide poisonings are preventable if you take the proper steps to protecting yourself and your passengers.
The Tournament Trail, for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM, Smyrna Readiness. Serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Well, folks, there's a lot of you that are fishing tournament trails out there, and there's a lot of you that want to follow the progress of those who are fishing those trails. And the best way to do it is right there at our Fishing Affliction Facebook page. If you're fishing a trail or a tournament, feel free to post the results there at our Facebook page, and you can keep up with others like Slammin' Sam Lashley, The Machine Toby Lillard, Miss Laura Mae Cochran, and of course our very own Big Dog, while they're fishing the tournament trail. Our many thanks to Smyrna Ready Mix for sponsoring the tournament trail, and now back to Fishin' Affliction TV.
Yeah. That was on a swimming caffeine shed.
That's a new one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Look at that. That's good paddle tail, huh? That's
good
great.
Looking bait.
Look at the top of his head, Victor. It's kind of...
He's a knothead, just like you, man. Y'all have something in common.
Put him on my side so my other fish can eat.
Yeah, you wish your fish was that big.
Good fish, big dog.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good solid fish.
Modified Strike King triple rig. Some redfish magics. And a big Percy Priest largemouth. Pretty nice, huh? All right, buddy.
All right. Put him in the box.
My side.
All right, good job. Been a little bit, but we finally caught one.
He just spit him out of shad, big dog. That's neat, huh?
Yeah, he did.
Man, they just inhale that bait, don't they?
They're eating that swim bait, aren't they?
That's awesome, huh?
Look at the color of his eyes. Boy, he's almost like a red eye, isn't he?
Doesn't have any tooth patch, does he?
No.
Let me ask you, how much did he like the swimming caffeine, Chad?
I think he ate the whole thing. It was back in his stomach.
That's cool.
Not a giant, but fun to catch. You know, one thing that we're not used to, or that I'm not used to, and I've been fishing this lake since I was 13 years old. So, I mean, it's been a long history of me on this water. But one thing I'm not used to is the amount of brush and growth that's in the water this year. And it's because they held the lake down so long last year. And I'm gonna tell you, these fish are using it. They're using it for ambush points, and I'm gonna tell you, it'll probably help the spawn out a ton. And I can't imagine when the crappie all come shallow, how many crappie are caught out of it.
Will we be crappie fishing later today?
I won't unless they'll eat. I'll catch any crappie that'll hit a 5.5-inch or 6-inch caffeine chain.
Right, here we go. Big dog, I think you found out what they're liking. Woo! Gosh, me. That is awesome.
Good chunk.
Healthy fish, huh?
Look at that, his pigment's changing. They do that a lot when they're on bed.
Nice fish, big dog.
Well, thank you, Dan. That's five. Good job. That's
all right. Five. All right, big dog. Wind's picking up and another good one.
Nice. Now, I know y'all think I got a funny hat on today, and I do. But I'm going to tell you, so far this year, I have absolutely had my ears burn off. And I've got to get it stopped. And Academy sells these things. Yeah. They work good. Uh-oh. That's what you call another keeper.
Good for you, baby. Yes.
Did you take one of my fish out of there?
No, but I am missing one of mine.
Hey.
My first keeper, but did not go in the box, if you remember.
Dan, I don't really think that fish measured.
Well, you said it was a keeper. We asked. Way up there, big dog. Way up there.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Not a keeper.
What are you saying?
I don't think that's a keeper.
Well, I'm glad you don't think so. But let's see what the measuring stick says. Because it's become violent in the boat. Violent.
It could be. Ooh, wait a minute. Hold on a second.
What is that?
Hold
He's
on
touching?
A second. No, that ain't touching. His mouth's got to be closed.
His mouth is touching right there, and his tail is touching.
Dang, he barely measures. That's a 16th of an inch. All right, put him in your side. How many you got? Four?
Quattro.
I got four. You got four.
I got five.
Ooh, look at them big buffaloes. Okay.
Well, folks, after catching my fifth keeper of the day, but only the fourth one that we had kept, and watching these big buffalo go through their spawning rituals, it was time to show you all our Percy Priest pre-spawn catch of the day.
Man, this one's got some chompers on it. All right, here's our four best ones from Percy Priest today, and mine's biting the fire out of me. And quit laughing, it ain't that funny. Anyway, there's our four best from Percy Priest today. We're going to let these go. And we got four more keepers in the box, but we're going to let them go too, and then try to catch one or two more before dark. But, you know, we had 11, 12 keeper bites today. Dan had some good flipping bites in behind me today and caught the best fish. I'll fess up to it, although I really hate to.
Oh, anyway, look at that, folks.
I mean.
There, you want to touch him?
Thanks a lot. Anyway, we've had a nice, fun spring day, and Dan can't even hold the fish.
They're
but
just
anyway,
flopping here they go. He's very healthy. Thank goodness he's okay.
All right.
Big Dog, would you get my fish out of the fly wheel for me?
Well, somebody needs to.
I think that should be a new Fish and Affliction rule. The person who doesn't catch the biggest or the most fish has to take care of all the fish. You could be the live well boy. Oh, live well boy, please get my fish.
You want me to get your fish?
Just go on.
Here he is.
Hey, we did have a... But you see what I was saying about mine? My fish were bigger?
That one ain't too bad.
Yeah, monster. That's a big one. Oh, what a beautiful sunset.
Well, folks, there's no doubt that the Big Dog and I had a whole bunch of fun fishing the pre-spawn there on Percy Priest Lake and enjoying this stunning sunset on the way back to the ramp. But just because we were getting off the water, that didn't mean that the spawn was over. As a matter of fact, I was heading to Old Hickory Lake the very next day. Because when it's spawning time here in Middle Tennessee, not only can big bass be caught, but big monster rockfish can be caught too. And I'm going to show you both when we get back to more Fish and Affliction TV. But right now, it's time to head upstairs to the kitchen to see what Miss Vicki Porter's got cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter, and as we continue with our healthy fishing snacks, today I have a tasty spin on a classic favorite. It's my tuna salad and tomato wedges. And now for the ingredients. You will need hard-boiled eggs, tuna fish, mayonnaise, honey mustard, pickle relish, celery seed, seasoning salt, pepper, tomatoes, and olive oil. After you've chopped your boiled eggs, mix them in with the tuna fish. In a separate bowl, mix together your mayonnaise and your honey mustard. Now add your olive oil, your celery seed, your pepper and your seasoning salt, and last your pickle relish. Now let's take that and put it over your tuna fish and the eggs, and then get it all stirred together. Cut your tomatoes into wedges and use these for dipping instead of crackers, and you will have a healthy and delicious snack to take fishing. You can find this recipe at intheskillet.com. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the Skillet.
As fishermen, we're predators, and fish are the prey. In nature, the best fishermen have one thing in common, their eyes. How do you turn your eyes into the eye of a predator? It takes 11 layers of lens technology and a new lens color to make the human eye emulate the eye of a predator. Stop buying glasses for the classes. Make yourself an alpha predator.
Hey everybody, it's that time of year again, believe it or not, time for Free Fishing Day across Tennessee. There's going to be a lot of events held for kids. You can go to TWRA's website, tnwildlife.org, go to fishing information and find out where all these events are taking place across the state, including in Middle Tennessee. And June 8th is Free Fishing Day. Now, these events that are being held are for kids, and there's a lot of information about the ages of kids, for which particular event. There's a lot of catfish being stocked in waters where these events will be held, but that's all for the kids. But you adults, Free Fishing Day is for you also. If you want to go to a Middle Tennessee lake like Percy Priest, Old Hickory, wherever, if you want to go river fishing, you want to go creek fishing, it's Free Fishing Day for you. You do not have to have a license on that day for either warm water species like crappie or bass or bluegill, or for cold water species like trout. Trout is not a permit. A lot of people think that's a permit, but it is a license. So on Free Fishing Day, go fish all day for free. You still have to pay attention to the krill limits, the number of fish that you can catch, but also size limits too. So just make sure you pay attention to those limits. But as far as having a license on that day, go have a good time. And we do Free Fishing Day in part to get kids involved in fishing, to get them into the future of fishing, and also maybe to rekindle the interest of some of you out there that put your rod and reels down a long time ago, or maybe some of those of you who never picked them up, but you are beyond the kid years. Anyway, Free Fishing Day, June the 8th, go to tnwildlife.org and check it out and get outside and go have a good time. And I'll see you next week right here on Fishin' Affliction.
On today's Fishin' Affliction product spotlight, it's about the great selection of lines from Seaguar. Whether it's fluorocarbon, braid, or monofilament, the lines that Seaguar offers are always the best and provide you the absolute top quality that money can buy. And with the new additions of their monofilament and braided lines, there's no doubt that Seaguar has a line for your favorite kind of fishing. So head on over to Seaguar.com and spool up your favorite reel with some of their great fishing lines, and you'll see why Seaguar is always the best. And now back to Fishin' Affliction. Welcome back to Fishin' Affliction TV, and this segment of the show is brought to you by Ranger Boats, still building legends one at a time. Mercury Outboards, number one on the water. Akuma, high performance fishing gear. The ever powerful and long lasting Deca batteries. Seaguar, always the best. Mustad Hooks, stays sharper longer. Onyx Life Jackets and Rain Gear, keeping you there. Freyville, trusted gear since 1938. Real Magic, the name says it all. Rugged electronic mounts provided by Ram Mounts. Wigwam Socks, the performance sock company. BBGmarine.com and Tournament Wear. Look great, feel great, do great.
Today is a special day.
Today is a very special day.
On Fishin' Affliction Television.
It
today.
Is.
We have what is happening today?
We have a special guest with us, my dear friend Belle. And so we're going to have a little bit of a in the boat tournament. It's going to be the girls against Dan.
Sister Belle?
I believe Dan's going to be in trouble.
Normally, that's the normal thing.
Well, folks, you heard them. It's the girls against Dan the Man today on Old Hickory Lake, and it looks like the deck's stacked against me. But what the girls weren't banking on is that I was going to go around the corner and make one cast with my Strike King umbrella rig and hook an Old Hickory monster rockfish again.
Sister Belle?
Oh.
No. Oh, my. Look at him go, Vic. Look at him go.
You better follow him.
Oh, he's at the surface. Holy cow. Holy cow.
Oh no, where's the net?
Where's the net?
The net's never out.
What's the net?
How deep? Sister Belle, right here.
Right there.
Open that door.
Just pull it through.
And there's a net, you'll be able to pull it out. Oh my gosh. That's great. Now, if you just extend it, there you go. Yeah, there's a little button. Yeah, just pull it back. There's a little button underneath. Look, there you go. Gosh, this is a tank. This is a tank. Sister Belle?
I think you're set on the net.
That's okay. Thank you. I want you to come see this. Come up here. Gosh, it's a turn off. There he is. Oh my goodness gracious. There he is. Woo! Look at this. Oh my, watch when he comes up. He's a big one.
He is a big one.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
He's a big one.
Holy cow.
He won't fit in the net. No, he won't fit. He's not gonna fit.
Oh my goodness gracious.
Where's the dolphin?
Oh my gosh. Sister Belle.
Oh my gosh. What do you want me to do?
I don't know. Hold that. Hold it. Oh my goodness me.
Oh.
What am I talking about?
Good night.
Oh my goodness gracious. What is that?
Wow.
What is this?
That's awesome.
What is that? What is that? That is a massive rockfish. It is. Isn't that unreal? Now, we got the best good luck charm on Vision Affliction TV. She's never not going to be in the boat.
She's always going to go now.
The first 5 minutes, there we are right there. Vision Affliction. We're going to get some measurements real quick. And do what we can do, because this is huge. That is what we're talking about.
Well, folks, this rockfish was right around that 35 to 40 pound range and was almost 40 inches long, an absolute monster. And once we turned it back loose to the wilds of Old Hickory Lake, I picked up my Strike King Red Eye, made one cast on the point, and caught a monster largemouth.
Like this looks like a big, oh my goodness, what a largemouth, what a largemouth. What a largemouth, stay on there. Oh my gosh, it's a tank.
That's a big one.
It's like a monster right there.
Cool.
Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness gracious. Strike King Red Eye. 5'3", 5 pounds, 3 ounces. After just 5 minutes or so in the live well, she's all good. She's full of eggs. I don't want to keep her here too long. Let her do what she's come up here to do, which is feed up and get ready to find herself a boyfriend so she can have youngins.
Well, folks, the girls were going to have a hard time catching bigger fish than I caught, but there was no way I was going to catch as many as they did. And Sister Belle got the hot hand towards the end of the day.
Swing them, swing them. Swing them.
Yay.
Go back there.
Let me see if I can get him off for.
Oh, my gosh. I want my bait back.
All right.
That's all right.
She's moving on up.
That's two casts and a rope.
Yeah.
Two casts.
I know. So she keeps doubling the size like that on every cast.
I thought we were leaving. Well, that's a great fish. Congratulations. Cool.
Well, folks, I might have caught bigger fish that day, but the girls caught a whole bunch more than I did, and they had a whole bunch of fun doing it. And we enjoyed having Miss Belle Pelez in the boat so much, and she has become the best good luck charm that you could ever ask for here on Fishin' Affliction TV, because that's the first time she was ever in the boat with us, and we caught that big old rockfish, a big largemouth, and a bunch of other bass. And folks, Team Fishin' Affliction is feeling so lucky that the big dog and myself are going to stay on Old Hickory for next week's episode, because we've got that loving feeling for big old hickory largemouths. So tune in to Fishin' Affliction TV next week, and you'll see.
Going to my side, big dog.
All right.
Do I have Oreos in my teeth?
No, you don't have Oreos in your teeth. Put the fish in the box.
That's a tank.
This week's Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend is
Anthony Kirk.
And thanks for being our Facebook friend. For your chance to join in the fun and become an official Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend, simply like us on Facebook. And be sure to write a comment on our wall. As always, a big thank you to all of our national and local sponsors for providing us with the most advanced technology and highest quality products and services. Be sure to visit each of our partners online through the sponsor links page on our official website at fishinaffliction.com. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin' Affliction TV, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt that Dan and the Big Dog got it bad. They've got Fishin' Affliction for those who got it bad.
All right, 3, 2.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here, 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 fishy.